Greetings and welcome to Turismo, the real Grand Driving Simulator 7. So, we're still working on completing the world circuits. I don't know how I forgot about the name of them. I was going to say world touring, which is true. We're trying to do the world touring races. Since we basically did all the Group 3 stuff, we did all the Group 4 stuff. We did all the basic stuff. I basically have nothing to do in this game other than to, you know, just get trophies for no reason. I don't really want to deal with Daytona, but we're going to have to deal with Daytona. So, oh yeah, we do have like 600 performance races. Let's go find those and do those. Oh, there's one. World Touring Car 600. They're all going to be normal cars. Quote, normal. No air quotes. Let's see. Let's use the Supra. Because the Supra is at exactly 600. Let's double check its settings real quick. That's... Yeah, all good. And for the most part, I will admit we have nitrous installed, but that's more as a backup. Like if somehow we can't catch up to them because reasons. That she takes makes that first corner is just amazing.
Thank you.
traffic action, we practically passed. Hi there. I'm gonna give you a chance. Because I need to use nitrous to catch up to you. Man, you're going fast. Definitely could have done better. But whatever. Wait, the Supra that I passed is a model younger than the one that I'm currently driving? Ah, whatever. Give me my monies. Dang, didn't get the clean race bonus. Oh well. Alright, that was a good 10-minute race. I feel like we should do one more. But I'm not sure where to go. So we have a group. Excuse me. There's a Group 3 race there that I didn't do? Well, I guess we'll go do that then. Let's see, 7:30. Not sure of what cars I can use. I can pretty much use anything. The 4GT LM is kind of tempting. But the F-Type has a little bit more horsepower. Although weirdly, the Nismo has even more horsepower. And I'm pretty sure that thing has a ballast and a power restrictor on it. So I'm not sure how that's possible. Let's check the GT real quick. Wait, this thing actually is restricted. Oh, okay. So it's supposed to be like 770 and I toned it down. Well, I guess we'll just use this. Let's double check. You never know. It seems like it's going to rain and I don't like that. Are gonna make me actually use my nitrous this time. Ah, you're gonna brake check though. that's annoying. Wow. That GTLM over there decided to really swing wide. Not sure why it did. That wasn't really a problematic turn. I'm gonna do this now. You guys ain't never catch up to me. It seems like the recommended gear that they want me to drive in is always gonna have way too much torque in it. Try to swing out of the corner. I have no idea why it wants me to do this in second gear, considering third gear would be perfectly fine. The other Ford GTLM is having problems because it cannot pass those other cars. That was a nice drift that I didn't notice because I was paying too much attention to the mini map. I don't understand why they're designed with the idea of having tire degradation and fuel consumption when it's, you know, lap dictated. So we have to do, you know, 5, 10, 15 laps. And these 5 lap races, which have fuel and tire degradation, don't really give us a chance to get into the pit to be able to refuel and freshen up the tires. That was a late break. I'm going to be going off the track. I didn't go too far. Okay. Anyways. But yeah. I don't really understand why there's fuel and tire degradation when we're not going to be going into the pit. So at that point, I don't see why they would bother adding that feature in a race that's not going to require it. Like, I know there's the 10 lap races have like 8 to 12 times degradation on tires and fuel. That's way too wide. But then, of course, that makes sense because with it being 10 to 12 times faster depletion, you're going to need. You're gonna need to go into the pit. Whereas here, it's at like 7 or 6, maybe 8. And I'm not really feeling any need to go into the pit, even at 5 laps. Like, I could probably go for another 20, maybe even 21 laps before I need to actually go into the pit to change out my tires. Granted, the game is supposed to be a simulator, but if you're going to simulate that stuff, at least give me a reason to, you know, go into the pit for it, to be able to fix it, rather than just being there to be there. Alright. Well, surprisingly, that was only a 12-minute race. It felt like it took a lot longer than that. But whatever. That just means it'll be the second portion of the video, and also where we will end today's session. Oh, what? You actually know what? I did check the legendary cars recently, and I saw something there that I want, and it's this thing. I think for the fun of it, we're gonna buy it. At 10.5 million frickin' dollars. Which sucks. But, I mean, I have the money, I just don't wanna spend it. Cause I'm stingy like that. F1 GTR. Why is it also called the BMW? That makes no sense. Well, whatever. It's mine. That's all that matters. Buy it. Just throw money at them. Ta-da. Actually, isn't that the McLaren that I was facing off against not too long ago? Wow. Look at them points that I can't use. Let's see. I know I don't want to get in that car. Are you insane? But, whatever. Regardless. That will be the end of today's session. So, I don't know why I went into the car sheet right there, but whatever. Let's go to, yeah, let's go to there. So, like I said, that'll be the end of today's session. So, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Stay safe. Take care. And we will see you in the next session.